Since I was a little girl, I've had this innate curiosity and wonder about the physical world and the universe. And so doing this major, I'm able to study and understand at the fundamental levels the physical world and continue to contribute to our understanding of where we all come from and where the universe came from and started.
Growing up, I've sort of always known that CSU would be the place for me. And actually, as a little kid, I would tell my parents that I wanted to be a mathematician. Not really your normal little kid, I'm gonna be job, but they had me reading G is for Google as an alphabet book. But then in high school, when I took my first physics class, that's what really drew me into the physics major, because I've always been sort of interested in how things work.
So when I started out, I knew I wanted to do astronomy, and astrophysics is basically the same thing. And if I wanted to go to grad school and have a career in astronomy, I also knew I had to take physics, because those are the fundamental laws of nature. So in astrophysics, you don't take any core classes until you're a sophomore, second semester. And the first class you take is Intro to Astronomy, or astrophysics, and it's a really great class. It covers everything. And then in your junior year, you get to go into the more exciting and deeper classes, such as galaxy evolution and stars, and you're learning about more specific parts of astronomy. The University of Minnesota is a top research university, which means that there's a lot of professors here eager to get undergraduates working with them. So coming here to the U of M, I've been able to get into research early on, which is crucial to a career in astrophysics.
So it's really cool just being in and around faculty who are famous in their fields and have done some great work. My quantum mechanics professor actually just collaborated on a project that ended up winning a Nobel Prize in physics. So being so close now in college to what's actually going on in my field and not just reading in a textbook about things that we learned 200 years ago is really fascinating to me.